All right, so Vimeo been around for quite a long time, since 2004 actually. We started with ClickHouse 2 years ago for the reasons you're gonna see in the presentation. And in this presentation, I want to share why we started with ClickHouse and the experience we had with ClickHouse and a few tips and the entire journey. So again, what type of data we actually collect? You go to the video and we create a session. A session contains a lot of dimensions, which country you're watching from, which device, and each session builds from micro events. So each micro event can be a load, a play, and different heartbeats, different user interactions you do while you watch the video. And those micro events build a session, and from those sessions, we build analytics. So views, skips, and whatever the user, whatever you can think about in terms of analytics. In terms of the volume, in terms of the data size, again, we redact the analytics, of course. It's around petabytes of data. The data comes all the way from 2007, so it's quite a lot. We have close to actually 1 billion videos in the company, so it's many, many videos. So it's a lot of data, around 20 billion micro events coming in that we process. It's important to note that we have different types of videos. We have regular videos, we have live videos, we have webinars, we have venues, and all of those type of videos, we need to provide analytics for different use cases. For live videos, the analytics use case is much, much faster, much lower latency versus a regular video where the latency can be a few seconds, can be a minute, but it's okay. In terms of demand, we have around close to 30 to 40 million SQL calls a week. The demand is almost even between live and non-live videos. It's important to note, which is very common in analytical systems, is what is called the Pareto principle, which is the majority of the data, like the majority of the queries, will come to the top 10%. And this is important as I go with the slides, because with the design, you're gonna see with any analytic system, the data can and the analytics and the query time can get messed up based on those users. We have different use cases, again, for user-facing analytics. We have for internal analytics, for BI, cross analytics across regions, across devices. And again, it's a very important use case because many databases cannot provide you this type of analytics. ClickHouse actually does. Before ClickHouse, what we used to have, which is used to be very common in most analytical systems, it is OLTP architecture. In our case, we had HBase, which is a JVM base, key value distributed storage. We add in addition Apache Phoenix, which allows us to write or use SQL commands on top of HBase. In terms of performance, HBase was a really, really shitty one. It was not great. You know, we spend a lot of money and insane amount of nodes. Still, outages kept happening. Like big queries didn't work. Like those users couldn't get the data they wanted. Analytics for them was like most of them, most 10% of users got timed out. Like they just couldn't get their data. So it was a mess. We tried to scale horizontally, didn't get the reward that we wanted. So eventually we had to change, which we did. So we explored different solutions. We had different solutions we looked at. The three main ones that we looked at was Druid, Apache Druid, which is open source, again, based on JVM. MemSQL, which is based in memory, and ClickHouse, which is what we eventually decided to use. The POC, we tried to stress test it as much as we can. Because we faced so many outages with HBase, we want to make sure whatever solution we choose, it can survive whatever we have. So we started with a sample data of 25% of the data that we have. We started small and iteratively we went up. And we did whatever you can figure out, right? Ingestion, realistic queries. We dropped the zookeepers out, the machines out, we brought them back up. We want to make sure everything is consistent, the data is there, nothing got messed up. And the results, you know, ClickHouse just beat everyone by far. Like I can be the best salesman for ClickHouse because it's actually one of the best product I worked with. Compared to HBase, it's actually 10 times faster than what we used to have in terms of query performance. 4 times less machines and around 3 to 5 times less storage. ClickHouse is just, we used it for 2 years and we are very, very happy with the product. In terms of architecture and how we deployed, we actually deployed ourselves for now. We use self-managed Kubernetes on GCP, on Google Cloud. We use an open source tool called ClickHouse Operator, which managed updates and deployed the cluster. The way we do backup, we use an open source Valero tool, which backs up all the configs, the Kubernetes configs. We use a GCP API to store to backup the persistent volume. In terms of the cluster itself, we have only two replicas and five Zookeeper nodes. And another trick to save a bit of money is to use multi-tier storage between SSD and HDD, where the default is SSD. You're going to see in the next slide. This is in terms of data modeling. We mostly use, which is very common, the merge tree family engines. We use, in our case, replicated merge tree and aggregated merge trees. We do use some dictionaries and stuff to do different updates and joins. But this is the main families we use. You can see how we use how we move from SSD to HDD. We have a set of TTL where the default is again SSD, and then the rest move to HDD, let's say after a few months. Again, very common data compressions and data types. You know, Delta with ZSTD. You know, when the cardinality is very low, you use low cardinality. And let's say we use locations, right? We have device we have location analytics. So instead of using latitude and longitude, which is UN64, we just use H3 index. It's an open source algorithm. ClickHouse supports it, combines both of them into H3 index, which is just UN64. And a lot of stuff like that, right? So in terms of the design of data model, you go very similar with how everyone recommends you to do, low cardinality to high cardinality for order by and primary key, with the filters that you always use, right? So this is the stuff you need to have. And then we also use distribution table on top of them. And the trick here, which I cannot overstate enough, is the distribution key. If you distribute it too much, it creates too many parts. It's just everywhere. The replication queue, which is what you have in Zookeeper, it's just too many of them. The replication queue is just too high, and then Zookeeper just cannot handle it. Or if you queue it too little, then everything stays in few nodes or one node, and the memory in that node is just too much, and the queries are not efficient because they're not distributed. In terms of ingestion, we use Apache Spark, which is an open source processing engine. From Apache Spark, we use structured streaming, which allows you to have exactly once processing. So with exactly once processing, we insert into a null table. So a null table, if you don't know in ClickHouse, doesn't store any data, any parts, nothing, right? We use null tables just to use it for materialized views, which then we ingest to distributed table. So essentially, we move the distribution out of Spark to ClickHouse. So again, this is where the sharding key comes again, because this is how it gets distributed between the nodes in the cluster. We use different configurations as well, like insert deduplicate equal to one, duplication windows, how many blocks you store in Zookeeper to know which one to deduplicate, which again, because we use replicated merge trees and aggregated merge trees, if you have duplication, it can mess up the analytics. So this is why those configurations are really important. And another thing which we do, because we are user-facing analytical team, we want to provide also uniqueness, different unique metrics. So we use hyperlog-log, which ClickHouse support. It's called, we use unique combined state in the materialized views. And then in the aggregated merge tree, we combine the states together. When you query it, it's much, much faster. So this is one example we use for materialized view. We have different aggregation tables just for faster queries, of course. So we have for session, we have for country, we have for video, we have for a bunch of them. So when you query that specific table, it's much, much faster. So the query can be in very few milliseconds with those aggregation tables. This is one example of how we use a materialized view. Again, you read from a null table, which doesn't store any data. It's just when you ingest to it, you can query it, the block of data. And then you just do a distributed table. Inside this, you do the same stuff you do in every materialized view, right? So here we just want to show how we use HLL, hyperlog-log with unique combined state. Another way to make it more efficient, instead of using strings, we just hash the uniqueness to an integer. This way, it's less memory, easier to combine and do uniqueness. In terms of final thoughts, since we deployed ClickHouse 2 years ago, we had very, very few outages in terms of queries, no timeouts. Like before ClickHouse, we had a lot of timeouts. Now, most queries are less than a few seconds. The highest can be, again, less than a few seconds. So no queries take more than a few seconds. We can support cross analytics that we couldn't think of, right? Total views across all the users together, or like in different dimensions. So this kind of stuff. And again, with ClickHouse, there are many configurations that you can set up, which I didn't talk in this presentation, but there are many of them. We are also in the process of moving from Zookeeper to ClickHouse Keeper. We have a set of monitoring like Grafana, which allows us to monitor a lot of configs from Kubernetes, from Prometheus, about the cluster, about ingestion, about everything related to ClickHouse. And again, in terms of cost, very important for us at least, very, very cheap. Like in terms of the other solutions we explored, what we had before and what we have now and what we can support. In terms of cost, ClickHouse just blows it out of the way. It's very, very cheap for us and the quality is extremely high. And again, I want to take this opportunity to thank my teammates, Siddharth Saha, Evan Potter, and Manoar Timaraj, and a few others in my team, Tadwak in my team. This is my 10-minute talk.